sisters, assalamu alaykum. Insha'Allah, you all are doing well. Happy Jumu'ah. It is Friday. I don't even say Friday anymore. Just say it's Jumu'ah. So happy, happy Jumu'ah. Thank God it's Jumu'ah. I slept well again. I don't know what's going on, but I am absolutely loving it. Loving it. I slept all the way up to my alarm, and I'm just gonna keep just saying how I sleep because I slept great again. So yay me. Let's see. Yeah, it's okay today. It's a little bit slow at times, not bad. I'm a bit bored out of my mind. But hey, what else is new? It's break time, alhamdulillah. So I'm just going to sit here and enjoy my break and watch the lawn people do what they do. It looks like they carved some grass out of the ground or something. It looks pretty ratchet. But anyways, I mean, look, looks pretty ratchet. Look at the ground. SubhanAllah. Ooh. But anyways, yeah, I don't know what I intend on doing this weekend. I can't really go anywhere really because my registration, I still need my sticker, so I just keep my travels very strict to just, you know, work and home and back. I don't really have the need to go anywhere. I would love to go see the new Tarbiyah house that Imam Aziz and their group got. I'm very excited about that. I read an email, or was it email? Yeah, email that shows, that says that they opened up a Tarbiyah house. So I look forward to going there and seeing that house, because usually when the Imam gives his khutbahs or, you know, Friday night, family night things, he does it at a recreation center in Rockland. So now they have an actual place to call their own, alhamdulillah. May Allah grant them success in that. Ameen, ameen, ameen. So I'm going to go ahead and enjoy the rest of my break. I've got 5 minutes, or less than 5 minutes. I'm going to read my book here and then go back to my... done with this day. It's 6:48, alhamdulillah. It'll be time to break my fast soon, and I have no idea what to have for dinner. No idea, and I need to figure something out. I don't want to cook. I really don't want to cook. I don't have it in me to cook. It's Friday. It's Jumu'ah. We shouldn't be cooking on Friday. It's a holiday. I may order a pizza. I don't know. I may look in the freezer for something to quickly thaw, but that's cooking. I don't want to cook. I don't want a sandwich. And after fasting, I really want something quick and maybe even something sweet, like a cookie. I've been craving something sweet all day, like some type of a cake or a cookie or a pie or something. And you know, I got a coupon in my email box for $1 off of a smoothie at Jamba Juice. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm gonna get that this weekend. I'm fasting. I'm still fasting. So I can't. And the coupon, I think, is going to expire Sunday. It says $1 off for the entire weekend. So I'm assuming it's going to expire on Sunday. And Sunday is the 20th. I don't know, sisters, I don't know. Yeah. Oh, I managed to get my vlog up and out on time for the first time in a week. I got it done. I had it completely uploaded late this morning. And then when I got home from work, I got straight to work on, you know, adding my description, my annotations, my cards, and whatever. Oh, my thumbnail. And I finally got it up scheduled on time. I was so proud of myself. Well, since I am proud of myself, I think I deserve something sweet. I'm going to get something sweet. I'm not going to go out anywhere. My registration is still... I don't want to drive anywhere. So let me see. I will call in for a pizza and maybe a brownie cookie. Or is it a cookie brownie? Either way, I think that's what I'm going to do. Because I want to reward myself. I want to reward myself that all this week, I got through the week in one piece. I had a bumpy road. Yesterday was my bumpy road. Yesterday was yesterday. I can celebrate the fact that I slept well last night again. And I didn't want to get up again, so inshallah, I will sleep well tomorrow. Maybe I'll, you know, my alarm is not even set on the weekend, so I may be able to sleep longer. Let's pray I'm able to sleep longer until the sound the adhan comes on. And I can always hear the adhan in my sleep. Always, always, always. I remember my husband, when he would call the adhan from the other room, and his voice is not even as loud as the electronic one that we have, but I would always hear his voice while I'm deep asleep calling the adhan. Always, without fail. So I think that if I have another awesome night's sleep and I sleep to the sound of the adhan, and the adhan is going off around 6 in the morning now. That would be completely new for me, to have slept beyond the time that I usually get up. And that would be the first. That would be awesome. So I will tell you how I slept tomorrow, inshallah. So, let me see. Let me make a call. No. Call logs, contacts. Let's see. Papa. Papa. a second. Let me not call them yet. I'm not even prepared. I'm not prepared. Sisters. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to call Papa John's. Bismillah. It's a simple pizza. Inshallah. Bismillah. Yes, I'd like to order a pizza for delivery, please. Could I get a large pizza, a large cheese pizza, uncut, with extra cheese? So, I ordered the pizza, a brownie cookie, and a root beer. And yes, it's junk food, but hey, like I said, I am rewarding myself for getting through this week, for fasting, for not having a mental breakdown yesterday, for a mental breakdown. Oh, subhanAllah. You know what oh my gosh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to read Surat al-Kahf. Oh, I think I'm going to try and read that now. I will get back to you in a little bit, inshallah. Afternoon, sisters. How are you? Assalamu alaikum. It's Saturday, 4:26 or 7-ish. Almost time for Asr. And I have been busy all day working on the computer. I was putting together something for my daughter to help her learn her grammar, usage, and mechanics in her lessons. And alhamdulillah, I didn't know how easy it would be to actually do a presentation for a video, like on Hangouts? No. I forget. Online Hangouts or something like that. Hangouts on air. Something like that. But I did a private video just for her so that she can have something to, you know, that will show her, you know, her lesson, what she's supposed to be learning, how something works and all that stuff. So alhamdulillah, I was able to put one video together using the Hangouts online, or what is it? I forget what it's called. But Google Hangout. Yeah, but not that, but I think it's Hangouts on Air or something. Yeah, I remember it says yeah, Hangouts on Air. So alhamdulillah. Now I'm just setting up for Quran recitation and I just got dressed. After not being dressed for a while, you know, I'm not dressed like, you know, dressed to go anywhere, but I just put on my abaya, my niqab, so I can get ready to record another episode, inshallah, and I am looking very much forward to it. I have been practicing Surat al-Layl all week long. And I'm going to practice it some more. I'm trying to get myself ready to record before the light starts to invade my spot. It's going to invade my spot and it's going to ruin everything. I'm going to have a ray of light just coming across my face and stuff. But anyway, yeah, so I've just been busy working on that. And so now half the day, more than half the day is gone. I am still fasting, alhamdulillah, which means I have one more day to fast. And then, inshallah, I will be fasting every Monday and Thursday. I don't know if I'll start next week. I may start the week after just to give myself a break from fasting and just, you know, enjoy and partake in food all, you know, all day, every day for next week, inshallah. But yeah, I did have to have a serious talk with my daughter, though. I did have to have a very serious talk with her because I have been very lax when it comes to giving her things or letting her enjoy things without really working for it, such as watching Netflix on the computer or playing on the tablet, you know, doing things, you know, like that. Well, very recently she has, more than very recently actually, she has not been managing her time wisely and getting her homework done. And so she would end up working, you know, past a certain time when I give her a deadline to have her work completed by. So since I had seen no improvements, I decided to take those things that she enjoyed away and have her work that much harder for it. So, you know, if she wants to watch Netflix, she has to show consistency in, you know, getting her homework done and studying and getting everything done in the time given, and, you know, just basically meeting a deadline and not just, you know, being lazy and combating that. And same thing for the tablet. She wants to be able to play the tablet for like an hour or two. Well, I took that away because, you know, again, she has to demonstrate that she is, that she has earned it. She has to demonstrate that she is worthy of playing on the tablet and or watching Netflix or doing something. So I had to take those things away. And when she asked if she could play on the tablet today, I said, you know, you have not done what I asked you to do all week. And what did I tell you before? I told you before that if you can't get your work done in the time given, if you cannot meet your deadline, if you can't do what you're supposed to, then you can't play on the tablet, you can't watch Netflix, you can't do what you've been doing all this time. You just can't. You have to earn it. So she got really pissed off at me and then, you know, started having an attitude and all this stuff. And I got pissed off at her and I said, no, wait a minute. I'm trying to teach you real life here. Because when you go out in the real world, no place or no one is going to come to you and see you as being reliable and always meeting your deadline and always being respectful and all that if you can't do what you're supposed to do. No job is going to hire you if you're being flaky. No one's going to calling you to do something because you don't get it done in the time given. You have to show and prove that you are the person to get the job done. You have to prove that you're the person that someone can actually call on when they need something, when they need help, when they need to get something done. You have to be the one that they can call on because you're reliable, respectful, and you are I can't even think of the other word, but responsible, that's the word, responsible. So, and these are the things I try to instill in her, try to instill in my kids, because it's very important. When they go out in the real world, what they learn at home, they gotta show that they have to carry that on when they leave the home. And I'm very adamant about that. So, I mean, they get mad when I say, no, you can't do this or no, you can't do that. And yet they want me to give them something without me receiving anything first. It's like, well, no, I don't do that. I don't do that at all. If you want something from me, you give me something. You give me something. You show me that you can do this consistently. If you can show me that you can do this consistently, for, you know, over a period of time, then we will revisit. And then when I give you your rewards, you need to show that you deserve to keep that reward by continuing to be consistent in whatever it is you're supposed to be doing. Period. That's, you know, period. You know, there are no ifs, ands, or buts about it. So, yeah, I got really mad at her and I just drilled it down into her brain. And I said, you know, at the end of the day, do you want to see yourself as successful? Do you want to be proud of yourself? Do you want Umi to be proud of you? Do you want Abby to be proud of you? Do you want to know that Allah is proud of you? If you say yes to all of that, then you gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta take care of business. You have to take care of business. Proper English mixed with bad English, not a good combo. I spent maybe 30 minutes talking about that to her. So, and inshallah, she's got it down. I mean, I just need her to break this bad habit, you know, and just really, you know, kick some butt by just doing what she needs to do. She says she wants to be successful. She says she wants to be proud of herself. She says she wants me to be proud of her at the end of the day. So I said, well, if you want that, then you need to work for it. You need to show me that you can do this. Because if you don't show me you can do this, then you can't do it in the real world either. So, yeah, she has to show that she can do it in the real world. But she has to prove it that she can do it at home. So, but anyways, I am going to go ahead and practice my recitation so I can finish setting up in my room to record the episode scheduled to go out tomorrow morning. I will see you all and talk to you all in a little bit, inshallah. Good morning. How are you? Inshallah, you're all doing well this Sunday morning. My daughter is trying out jelly sandals. It's 7:21. Yeah, she's trying on jelly flip-flops. And I was just telling her, look at these jellies. The clear jellies. It's so nice, mashallah. But I was just telling her, I used to have jellies when I was a kid a long time ago. And there was a creek near the apartments that I lived, and that had a rope hanging from a tree. I think it was a rope hanging from a tree, or I jumped across the creek. I can't remember which one. But when I was going across the creek, I lost one of my jellies in the water. So that was my little story of how I had jellies and lost a jelly. I think I got trouble from my mom for that.
Feet?
Four. If you find a four, are you buying it?
Here's a four.
Ooh, she found a four.
Yeah, it was all very lonely.
That one's cute, though.
Yeah.
Your toenails need some work, though.
Yeah. Wait, I think I'm actually a five.
This, maybe you get this, a five. Or... What size is that one?
That's a three.
That's a three?
This is only
12. 12? A baby 12?
Yep.
Let's see, 13, 2, 3, 1. Yep, there. What are those up there?
1, 1, 1, 1. Back. Back of the jelly shoes.
So no more? One.
They're all ones.
We can't find a five. Oh no. Is that the four?
Yeah.
Yeah, your feet are gonna grow. Your feet are too big for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need a five. Maybe we should check in the other aisles and see if they have any. I doubt it, but we can check.
This?
Yeah.
What's this?
No. And the combination of what you have in the basket and what you have on your feet, that's going to be more than that. Which do you want more?
I don't know. I just really like it.
Like what?
Because it has the frozen.
Well, how about you get the shoes and the bracelet? I'll get the bank. Yes, no, no, yes. You want the blue?
Yeah, as soon as I find five. Found it.
Put them down there. No, where the other. I'm not shimmery person. I'm not the shimmery type of person. But if you want shimmery, if you want shimmery, you get shimmery. If you want the blue with the sparkle, you get the blue with the sparkle. If you want that one that you're touching, get that one that you're touching. Assalamu alaikum, sisters. How are you? Inshallah, you're doing well. It's Sunday afternoon. 3:12 in the p.m. I'm supposed to be studying, but I have not cracked open a book all day. We went out, my daughter and I, we went out to Walmart and picked up a few things, and the idea was I was supposed to, as soon as I got home, deep condition my hair, and while my hair was deep conditioning and while I had a face scrub on my face, I was going to study while I waited for my hair and while I waited for my face to do what it needed to do under the scrub. But it didn't happen that way. So it's now 3 and the weather looks like it's going to rain outside, which means my natural lighting is not perfect for over there, and therefore, and I haven't cracked open a book, which means I haven't studied a word of hadith or Quran to do a video for what hadith am I reading today. Sad. But then I was thinking, well, I haven't really had a day of doing nothing. So I think I'm gonna take this time to actually just do nothing. Where's that hair? Hair, my hair. So yeah, I did my hair. It's wrapped up. I'm watching the Levine Life. I got a message that my friend is not going to do online halakas anymore. And that's what I look forward to watching or do attending each Sunday. So now I'm not happy. But she said it's not going in the way that she'd like it, but I wish she wouldn't, you know, stop doing it because it's very beneficial for us sisters. So I don't know, inshallah she'll change her mind. So I'm just going to sit in my room and just relax, and I will see you all in a little bit, inshallah, when I am more decent. All right. Do. Ooh. H-I-L-T. Hilt. It's too close to Hitler. I'll do Holt.
If you had a B, then it could be Bolt.
Do I have a B?
No.
Do I have a B? Okay, fine. Do I have P? Ooh. H-E-L-P.
Help.
Rescue me. Take me in your... Oh, no. Let's not do that. Help. Halt. Wait. It's supposed to be halt. That means stop, not halt. What the heck is a halt? Gotta look it up in a dictionary.
Okay.
I don't want to right now.
Me neither.
New. What is that evil laugh for? Ooh, news. News? You can stop. It's creepy. Dang it. When I say stop, it means stop.
Okay.
Ooh, creep.
Wait, you didn't say stop until now.
I'm saying it now. Okay. And again.
A rinse of fate. Like that rinse of fate?
I don't know.
Rise of fate.
Kid.
If you had knives, you can make it kids.
One kid is quite enough. Thank you very much. Gotta love that face.
What?
What? This is what I have so far.
I wanted to put Disneyland.
I'm sorry.
Disneyland is the closest I've ever got.
Let's see. I got a D H N V U
H D T V.
It's not a word.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. It's my dictionary of fun words.
You need to get rid of your dictionary, man. It's wrong.
No, it's not. It's kids, really.
Oh, it's not.
Seriously?
Seriously. Are you daft?
Now that almost sounds like you said, are you deaf? Are you daft? And he had that little English accent going on, too. Oh, where did that come from? She's over here cracking me up here. She comes up with the craziest things. Oh, my gosh. Are you daft?
Are you daft?
Are you from England?
Not yet, anyway.
Yeah, as soon as Trump becomes president, that's probably where we're headed. Under the protection of the queen.
Oh, my cheeks hurt.
Oh, my God. peel. The peel.
Peel.
G. Wait, huh?
Peel.
Stop it.
Peel.
No.
I'm trying to get a K.
No. Fine. You want a K? Okay, let me see.
Peel.
No.
I want to do the word.
I got another darn G.
I want to do the word K.
Well, stop.
Cake is yummy. Cake.
Good for you. I'm glad. Just stop. I've got another G. What is going on? Stop it! If I get another gosh darn G, I'm gonna make you eat them. I don't even know what to do with the G's. Okay, I don't even have an L to get rid of some of these G's. I was gonna do goggle. How do you spell goggle? G-O-G-G-L-E? Yes. Okay, I've got enough G's for goggle. No.
For free.
No.
Free.
I will no blast
it.
No. Let me look for a free L around here first, okay? Okay. I might even not even use it. I might just say bogus.
Or Google. Google. Do you have
another Do I have a U? I don't have another O, no. Bogus. Where's a B? Didn't I use a B? Oh, I have a B. Bo. Where's a U? Did I use a U? Did I give you a U? I gave you.
Actually, you gave me a P.
Oh, I did? I must have used the U.
I'll give you a
Where'd
U.
I used a U for hut.
I have three
no,
U's.
No, no, peel.
I have three U's. I'm gonna get rid of those.
Peel. Ooh. I got a U!
I got an O!
Hey!
Yay!
Wait a minute!
What?
I don't have a free S on here.
I don't have a... I don't have any more G's!
Oh, my God. Okay, ears. Mine. Don't want to go deaf. I don't want to go deaf. Stop it.
Peel.
Another peel. I don't want to peel anymore. What am I going to do with a W?
Gold digger.
That's not part of it. Now I need an L. Peel. That's on you. I got an E. What am I doing?
I got an A.
Okay. Where's a B? B.
Gold digger.
This is G. U.
L.
Bogus. There, bogus. I got rid of a G. Wait, did I? Yes, yeah. I did. Now I have one more G.
My throat hurts.
That's just too bad.
You don't mind.
As long as my throat hurts, I can't laugh so hard.
Gold digger.
Would you stop saying gold digger?
Ooh.
It almost sounds like a bad word now.
I need to find a free tea.
We're just having ourselves a good time playing bananagrams, alhamdulillah. I swear, as soon as the camera comes off, one of us is saying or doing something funny and it never gets caught. So, she's been complaining about how she's hungry. And I'm like, well, eat a snack. There's carrots and there's radishes. She loves radishes. But she could put like a little bowl with some carrots and radishes and a little bit of ranch together. Just don't offer me any because I'm still fasting. Today is the last fast for a while. At least for a week, inshallah. So here's what I've got so far. And so I've got these. Is that a Z? That's a Z. I've got these letters left, trying to figure out what to do with them. And then there are some letters that haven't been turned over or peeled yet. And those are her, if you can read upside down. And she's got tons of letters that she hasn't used yet. So, and then I'm watching See Ayana, where her fiance is doing her makeup. It's so funny how guys think they can do their girl's makeup. Oh, yallah. Anyways, it's been a pretty good day, alhamdulillah. I swear I did not crack open any books, nothing, and I feel bad because I should be preparing to do some videos, but I just needed a day off just to goof around and be quiet, and maybe not just be quiet all day, weeping, laughing, you know, just enjoying each other's company, playing bananagrams, being silly, alhamdulillah. So anyways, I hope you all had a great weekend. If you did, alhamdulillah, tell me all about it. What did you do? Did you spend time with your kids? And if you did, what did you do? But anyways, I'm going to go ahead. Oh, I forgot I got my headphones on. I'm watching video. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and conclude for the weekend, for the day. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. Leave a comment below and share with this video with other sisters in our ummah. You all stay blessed. Have a great rest of your weekend. I will see you in the next vlog. Stay blessed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I just said stay blessed twice. I said stay blessed twice all in like 30 seconds. Assalamu alaikum.
Don't forget to check out my previous vlog, Am I Having a Midlife Crisis? If you're into Quran recitations, check out episode number 7. And What Hadith Am I Reading Today? Episode number 9 is up and ready for viewing. As always, thank you for watching my videos. Stay blessed. Don't forget to subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.